Turtle Beach Call of Duty Black Ops 2 Tango, 5.1 double Ds, that's right, I'm talking about Dolby Digital, dual band Wi-Fi, no signals get across over here, oh yeah. It will have you saying Tango Tango Delta all night long. Use the customizable presets so you can hear who's sneaking up on your rear. Turtle Beach knows size matters, that's why they made this headset 3 times the size of the fattest heads. Equipped with an auto-off feature that'll turn the headset off at any time. Oh, yeah.
Wait, what?
Why did you make this so fucking big? Why? I don't understand. It's way too fucking big. It doesn't fit on my head. It sits down on my ears, and that's as small as it goes. And it's just resting there on my ears. I gotta wear a fucking beanie so it rests where it's supposed to. I don't know what the hell you were thinking making it this big, and then it goes even bigger. The only thing I can think of is, there we go! I was supposed to be wearing a wrestling helmet this whole time. That's how you're supposed to fit it on. It fits perfectly now. This is awesome. I didn't know I bought the wrestling edition. Sorry about that, Turtle Beach. I made the mistake. Okay. Enough fucking jokes. I don't know what the fuck they're thinking about with the size of this thing. What pisses me off is that I did a lot of research on it when I was buying it. I made sure, you know, I looked at the X500, I think it was, and they had like some kind of hissing problem. So I bought this one, which is supposed to fix that. And then I get this problem where it just auto shuts off in the middle of fucking playing games and shit. The battery's charged, everything's fine, so it shouldn't stop. But it does. It says as long as there's sound coming through the headset and you're talking into the microphone, it's supposed to stay on. It doesn't. And it's supposed to give you a warning before it shuts off. Mine doesn't. It just shuts off in the middle for no fucking reason at all. It's very, very, very fucking annoying. Before I get shit on by all the Turtle Beach fanboys, I'm going to come to your house while you're playing. And when you're talking to somebody, I'm just going to unplug your headset and see how you like it. See how fun that is. What an awesome headset that is. And you might ask, why don't you just go out and get a new one of their headsets, a new wireless headset from Turtle Beach? Well, those ones also have the auto-off feature. So how do I know I'm not going to get stuck with the same problem again? Why did they have this auto-off feature that you can't turn off? Give the consumer the option. If they want it, they can have it. If you're getting it for a kid and he doesn't know how to press the power button when he's done playing, then yeah, sure. But I'm an adult. I turn my headset off every time when I'm done playing. The other thing that sucks too is, when they have the little Turtle Beach booths at the, Target or Best Buy or whatever, they usually only have the wired headsets. This headset was completely different from the wired ones at the time when I was doing all my research and going out trying them on and stuff. This is way bigger than the ones that they had at the store. I don't know if they made it so you could play while wearing a hat. Maybe that was their thing, but if you want to play while not wearing a hat, it sits on your ears and you basically have to wear a hat unless you have a gigantic fucking head. The sound is great. The presets are awesome. The cushions are really soft. Everything about it is awesome except for the size and that auto-off feature that you can't shut off and it just ruined the experience for me. I know this is an older model, but I paid a lot of money for it at the time. I'm not going to invest that much money again and have it do the same thing down the road and then I'm stuck with it. So that's been my experience with the Turtle Beach wireless headset. So let me know in the comments below if you had a similar experience with Turtle Beach.